Hi everyone, it's Emmett from Pie My Life Up. In this video, we'll be showing you how to install the Jellyfin Media Server onto a Raspberry Pi. Jellyfin is one of the best alternatives to Plex. It is completely free and open source, featuring many of the features that Plex offers behind its paywall. This includes functionality such as live TV support, as well as the mobile apps. Jellyfin even offers support for additional media types instead of just movies and TV shows. It can even handle eBooks. Best of all, Jellyfin doesn't require you to have an account to be able to use its software, unlike Plex. While Plex still features more mature support than Jellyfin, Jellyfin is definitely a great alternative for setting up a media center on your Raspberry Pi, especially if you value things such as the privacy of your data. For this video, we will be running Jellyfin off of a Raspberry Pi 5 running Raspberry Pi OS Bookworm. However, these steps we are providing should work for older Raspberry Pis as well as newer versions of the operating system. Jellyfin will even run on Raspberry Pis that can only run 32-bit operating systems. However, we do recommend using 64-bit if your Raspberry Pi supports it. Additionally, we highly recommend that you set up a static IP address for your Raspberry Pi before you continue. If you need to know how to do this, we have left a link in the description below. Once you're ready to proceed, open up the terminal on your Raspberry Pi or SSH into it. Your first step will be to update the package list by typing in sudo apt update and pressing enter. Once the update completes, upgrade any out-of-date packages by typing in sudo apt upgrade space hyphen y and then pressing enter. Updating basically just ensures we have a clean base to work off of and out-of-date packages aren't going to cause us any issue. Before we can install Jellyfin to our Raspberry Pi, we will need to install two packages, namely kel and lsb release. We'll be using both of these packages to set up the official Jellyfin repository on your Raspberry Pi. You can install these packages by typing in sudo apt install kel lsb hyphen release space hyphen y and then pressing enter. With these packages now installed, we will want to grab and save the GPG key for the Jellyfin repository. The GPG key is basically a way for your package manager to ensure that the packages it is downloading are valid and weren't swapped out during transit. To grab this key, type in kel space https://repo.jellyfin.org/debian/jellyfin-team.gpg.key/pipe/space/gpg/hyphen-dama/pipe/sudo/t/slash/users/keyrings/jellyfin-archive-keyring.gpg/greater-than-symbol/dev/null. With the GPG key now saved, we need to add the Jellyfin repository itself to our Raspberry Pi by typing in echo space double quote deb space open square bracket signed hyphen by equals sign slash user slash share slash keyring slash jellyfin hyphen archive hyphen keyring dot gpg space arch equals dollar sign symbol open bracket space dpkg space hyphen hyphen print hyphen architecture space close square bracket space https colon symbol // repo.jellyfin.org/debian/$ open bracket space lsb underline release space hyphen c space hyphen s space close bracket space main double quote space pipe symbol space sudo space t space slash etc slash app slash sources dot list dot d slash jellyfin dot list. For the repository now added, we will need to run an update again so that the package manager will know that it can now install Jellyfin from the official Jellyfin repository. You can update the package list by typing in sudo apt update. If everything has been done properly, you should see that the update completes successfully and that it references the Jellyfin repository. All we need to do now to install Jellyfin onto your Raspberry Pi is to type in sudo space apt space install space Jellyfin space hyphen y and then press enter. Jellyfin will automatically install any additional packages it requires and it will also set up a new user called Jellyfin. Once Jellyfin has been installed, we will now want to do a few more things before we connect to its web interface. The main thing we will need to do now is make sure the permissions are correct on your media files. If the permissions aren't correct, Jellyfin will be unable to read in any of your movies or TV shows. For this next section, you will need to know the full path to where your media files are stored. These can be mounted on a USB drive or a network share, or located directly on your Raspberry Pi's operating system. In our example, we have a bunch of movies from the Blender Open Movies project stored in the /media/movies folder. Once you are ready to proceed, change over to the super user by typing in sudo space su and then pressing enter. You will know you are running as the super user as the start of the line will start with root instead of your username. Let's start by adjusting the permissions for directories within your media files by typing in find space followed by the full path to where your media files are stored, which in our case is /media/movies/ followed by space hyphen type space D, space hyphen exec, space chip mod, space 755, space curly bracket open, close curly bracket, space backward slash, and then a semicolon. What this command does is search through your specified folder and then runs the chip mod command on every directory that it finds. It will set the permission for these folders to 755. If you want a better explanation of what these numbers mean, we'll link to a guide in it in the description below. Now, we'll need to do something similar, but setting slightly different permissions for files. Type in find, followed by space, followed by the path to where your media files are located, followed by space, hyphen type, space F, space hyphen exec, space chip mod, space 644, space open curly bracket, close curly bracket, space backward slash, and then a semicolon. This command searches your chosen directory for any files and then runs the chmod command on it to adjust their permissions to 644. Essentially what we are trying to achieve here is allow any user to be able to read your media files, but not able to write to them. We are now done with this, so we can exit out of the super user by simply typing in exit and then pressing enter. We are finally at the point where we can now connect to the Jellyfin web interface and finish setting up this media server on your Raspberry Pi. If you've forgotten what your Raspberry Pi's IP address is, you can use the command hostname space hyphen capital I to retrieve it. In our case, you can see our IP address is 192.168.0.32. Now, open up your favorite web browser and go to http://:// followed by the IP address of your Raspberry Pi, which in our case is 192.168.0.32, follow this up with a colon symbol and then the port 8096. You'll be greeted by the Welcome to Jellyfin screen. Use this to select your preferred language and then click the next button. With this next screen, you'll be asked to fill out a username and password that will be used for your Jellyfin admin account on your Raspberry Pi. Fill out your details and then click the next button to continue. We can now begin to add media libraries to your Jellyfin media server. To begin this process, click the Add Media Library button. The first thing you'll need to do is select the type of media that will be stored within this library. In our case, we'll be selecting movies. You can now give this a different display name if you wanted to. We will be sticking with the default and then clicking the plus symbol to add our first folder to this library. Now use this section to select where your media files are stored. In our case, this is /media/movies. Once set, click the OK button to proceed. Jellyfin also allows you to set specific settings for this library. For example, you can select the preferred download language, the country/region, as well as more. Once you're happy to proceed, click the OK button. You can add as many different libraries that you like, but once you're done, click the next button to continue setting up Jellyfin on your Raspberry Pi. This next screen allows you to change the default metadata languages. Of course, these can be controlled per library, but set these to what your default language should be and then click the next button. You can now control whether outside access should be allowed to your Jellyfin media server. You can even enable UPnP, but this doesn't work in a lot of cases. You will likely need to port forward port 8096 to gain access to Jellyfin outside of your home network. Once you're all set up, click the next button. You have now successfully set up the Jellyfin media server on your Raspberry Pi. All you need to do now is click the finish button. Now fill in the details for the user that you created during the setup process and then click the sign in button. You now have full access to the Jellyfin web interface. You can now watch any of the movies or TV shows they've already added, as well as access all the admin tools that allow you to control how Jellyfin runs on your Raspberry Pi. Hopefully at this point, you have also managed to get this media server up and running on your Raspberry Pi. If you like this guide, be sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe. Until next time, have a good one.